Now we'll look at the shear strain derivation. So this is the model which we have known. The chips are coming in terms of stacks, and the known values are phi and alpha, and the AB was my transition surface. The tool is shown, the job or the workpiece unfinished surface is this. This is the finished surface. So ACDB is the initial chip position. Before means, let me just clarify this. This before means BEFORE. That's the before. Now that is ACDB is the initial position before the tool moved from B to D. So it was at over D and this was my chip. So when my tool was at position of D, my chip was looking like this. But when my tool moved from D to B, my chip has moved upside and it is right now over here. So let me use another color. So when it is at point B, my chip has moved and this is my final position of that chip. Now let's come. Then EFGH is the position of chip after the tool has moved from 2B from D. So that I have shown EFGH. The strain triangle is shown. So the constant strain triangle will be, this is the strain triangle. So the strain is defined as distance traveled. That is the distance traveled and the perpendicular distance. So this is what I have got earlier. I have just transported the triangle. So phi angle is over here. The alpha is over here. And I have this parallel line for the chip. So this phi will be same as this phi. And this is a perpendicular made and a point X, which is that perpendicular line on the line GD. So using that triangle, the phi, the strain by this definition is DG by BX is equal to DX plus XD. DG is that this distance traveled, and this is that perpendicular distance somewhat equal to BX. This is that perpendicular distance. So I just splitted that and got the value dx plus xg divided by bx, and from trigonometry I am getting shear strain gamma is equal to cot phi plus tan of phi minus alpha. So as my phi reduces, t2 will increase. So that's the understanding. I am having a larger phi, I am having a smaller phi. My t2 is going to be increasing if I reduce the value of phi. So smaller phi, I will have thicker chips form, and my smaller phi, the strain is going to also increase. So that's the conclusion from there. In the next video, we'll look at a numerical question on this. Thank you.